what? And this was my 6-month-old nephew, who used to always slide off my door, enter like this crawling, would come to me when I would be having my coffee and that murmura namkeen, which keeps you slim and healthy to eat, and would pick one, eat one, and disappear. After every 5 minutes, he'll come back with the same thing, open the door, bua, bua, and eat one again, and we'll go back. This went on for almost, not just once, twice, but every evening when I was on my break from my job. I never used to feel that anger, frustration, irritation, or disturbance, but there was always a feeling of joy, the joy of giving. He was definitely intruding my space. He was definitely eating up my food. And obviously, I didn't want to mention the third one, but it's okay. He was disturbing me from the purpose that I was on to. But there was this extreme joy of giving and not pushing anything for anyone. You must be wondering, why am I telling this story when I all have to do with a sales training speech? Okay, so let's talk about the sales. At every moment, every point in time, wherever you are, whatever role you are playing, or whosoever you are interacting with, all that you're doing is sales. Right? I picked it from Burt Lancaster when he said, sell yourself first if you want to sell anything else. I was not selling myself, and my nephew was entering my room again and again. Why do you think this story helped me start the speech? Okay, no answer. Thank you. I'll come to it. But let's talk about sales first. Just like Toastmaster of the Day very beautifully mentioned that I used to hate sales. I used to think that sales as a bad rep. Even when I was a business development manager at my family business, I used to say, no, I don't do sales. I do business development. When I was a client service person at mydala.com, I never used to say I do sales. I always used to say, I engage the client. That client engagement is not sales. Until 2017, when I realized that all I do at every moment with whosoever and whatsoever is all sales. When I'm talking to my mom, convincing her for a girl's night out, I'm selling an idea. And she is telling me an excuse of not going out, it's late, and it's telling. When I'm at a Toastmaster meeting and there's a new member walking up to me and he would ask me, what have you been doing for so many years? You're not a BPM yet. I'm telling you again an idea that Toastmaster is a wonderful platform which has helped me evolve as a person. It does not matter what title I carry, but that idea or my experience of Toastmaster is a sales. When I go to work or probably work on some content for my trainings or my digital product that I'm doing right now, there are so many experiences that happen when I have to convince someone, talk to someone, persuade someone, inspire someone, motivate them to do something, and that everything is nothing but sales. Can you look back in your life and see that even if you are listening to me right now, it's that very same relationship? I'm trying to sell you something in the next 18 minutes and you're going to sell me your time? Is it so? So I broke this conception in my own head in 2016 that sales has no bad rep. Sales is not bad because all we have to do all the moment is sales. We can call it bad, that's okay. But I would make sure that what I'm doing right now is not bad. Because I have a reason for it. I'm deeply inspired by Simon Sinek. I heard his first TED talk where he said, and his book, The Why, in which he beautifully mentioned the golden circle. Now, this golden circle was not actually being told in the context of particularly organizations or human beings. But I want to relate this golden circle to your life. Wherein, what we see is the outer circle is what we do. Simply, everyone knows what we do. At any moment of time, if you are talking to a boss, talking to a nephew, talking to a parent, talking to a colleague, we know what we are doing. The second and probably the most important word I used to think was the how of how do you do what you do? Do you know how and what kind of effort you are putting to get done what you want to do? But what is the most important and the core of this entire process and not just the golden circle is the why? Why do you do what you do? What's your purpose? What's the belief that is letting you do that? What's the you? We'll move on to all the three circles and see how this is going to change our perception about sales and particularly how it changed my perception towards sales. When we talk about what, to me actually I would say it does not matter much, but still you need to know it. Every sales professional trainer would tell you that you need to know your subject. You need to know what you're selling. You need to know your services. You need to know what is it that you're trying to convince your people for. But not that much important either. Move on to the how. Now, how is something where I want your answer. How has been divided into three. The pre, the during, and the post. Let's assume any sales process. What is the pre-sales process that we want to get into or what we have to get into? Anyone? The pre-process.
Research.
Research, wonderful. Knowledge. You need to know your product. What else? What do we need to prepare for?
The pocket sale of the customer, where he is spending and the demographics and...
The demographic, the customer survey, I would say. So you have to know it all to know the pre thing in the training. Anything else that you are missing?
Sales pitch.
The emotional attachment of the customer to the product. If you are emotionally attached to the product, this kind of pattern, it's more of a personality than of a sort.
I think it's wonderfully framed, Rupinder.
The fine vibes and the one customer.
Okay, thank you.
The sales pitch. Huh? You have to prepare the sales pitch.
Okay, the sales pitch, a part of it comes in the pre definitely, and always any sales professional would agree to it, and all of you, because now all of you are actually a salesperson, would agree that you need to prepare. You don't know what is the reason for night out, how would you convince your mom? How would you convince your boss if you do not have a valid reason to take an off? Because you're just trying to sell an idea to him that I want to stay home and work from home. The pre is important in one more aspect. What are the thoughts and intentions that you are bringing on the table? It might sound like we are getting into the why, but it's not the why yet. What intentions and what thoughts you are bringing into picture, what belief you have before even you land in the front of the customer or the client is what determines how the sale is going to be. If your positive approach and if your inclination to get things done is stronger than anything else, no excuse can overpower your sales. That's what and where the pre matter. Coming to the during part, I think everyone would know all the during thing. During the sales or during any sales interaction, what is it that you are looking at? Anyone?
Sales experience,
you are selling him an experience. Him or her experience.
Customer is the time of during the sale, what is the experience while purchasing, the ease of purchasing the product.
Okay, but how do you create it? That's the question here. How?
The conviction with which you try and sell something.
That will depend on
answering queries.
Asking queries, wonderful.
Whether they are interested or not.
Whether they are interested or not, knowing them, talking to them, talking about them, and talking for them. I still remember when I was interacting with one of my clients and I entered the Saplab's office, all I could admire first was how beautiful is your office. And I was able to close that sale in the next 10 minutes. And mind you, we didn't speak about anything of what I do. Not at all. We just spoke about what they do, what their employees want, how their office work, what is the culture that they have, how happy or unhappy they are. That's it. I just spoke about them. So it's very important that during the process, whenever you are interacting with the sales, it's not about you, it's about them. It's about their story, it's about their experience, it's about their needs, their desires. And more than that, everyone would agree to me that your words matter a lot. Whatever you say and how you say matters a lot. And here comes a very important concept of positioning statement. How you position yourself. Simon Sinek has wonderfully picked the example of Apple, and I know most of you would have already heard it in Apple talk and in Simon's all the talk that he has done so far. I just want to create a very unique difference in positioning statement by giving you an example. If I have to introduce myself and if I tell you, I'm Hani Khanduja, I'm an experiential learning trainer and product consultant. I work with Blue Sky Learning. Bam. And there's another way. We are an organization who believes in empowering people by working on their behavioral aspect. We let them realize how they do things and why they do things they do at work and at their life. We change lives through small sessions of games. This is what Blue Sky does. Was the second one better? Was the second one more impactful? Did the second one connect with you strongly? Sorry for this one. But this is exactly the reaction when somebody introduces you to someone and like, I do this, I belong to this, and I am this. Rather than, this is what I serve, this is what I do to community, and this is what my intention is. In the second approach, I didn't say a word about who I am, what I do, and why do I need to close the sale. I really no need to close the sale at all. In the second positioning statement, the sale is automatically closed because the idea of empowering people, serving the community and helping them is more stronger than who I am, what I do and what my organization is going to do with them. This is where the during thing matters. In the during things, it's only the positioning statement that empowers your sales pitch. Shivpriya beautifully mentioned the sales pitch preparation, that is where it comes with the during. Adding to the during part, definitely how you dress, how you be, how you sit matters a lot. Your body language, your face expression, your tone, your voice, everything matters. I did hear something when a sales professional trainer told that if a client is sitting right in front of you, you can actually practice mirroring. It is an NLP concept which I still don't agree to because there are several clients who might be stern, who might not be very much inclined toward your idea, and if I also mirror them, so mirroring for the benefit of the client is the term which is used. If I am the one who's trying to close the sale and if Prashant is my client and he's sitting like this, what I should be doing ideally by closing the sale is, I would try to mirror him sitting like this only. He would feel more closer to me because I am replicating his body language. He is looking at it as a mirror. But I would still leave this for you to try and test. Because I personally think that there are more clients who might be stern, who might not have a very good body language, and if you also replicate them, it might not be very good. And I always believe that sales is an evolution process. You keep on trying strategies, you keep on evolving with new methods, and you realize what works for you and what doesn't work for you. Because it's really about you. Moving on to the next part, the post. Why do you think the post sales is important? I can just take one opinion. Why do you think the post sales is important?
For making stronger relationship and the getting the repeated businesses.
Repeat business and stronger relationship. Thank you so much, Sandeep. Maybe you want to add something else? Close. Your customers and your sales is not about just this moment. It's about a lifetime. It's about retention and it's about your commitment. And very strongly, we have a very good experience for the pre. We prepared, we did a lot of research, we had a very good body language, we prepared, we were looking sharp, we were very good at the meeting. And we committed that we'll send you the module by 10 a.m. tomorrow. And then 10 a.m. never happened. I failed at my commitment and the post thing failed seriously. Because the post thing can actually erode everything that you did in the pre and the during. So what you commit to your client is very important to be fulfilled. And even if you can't, then the very convenient mode is communication. You communicated to them that we will not be able to do it. Please give us more time, because that communication is going to take you longer. So these are the how that I believe in, of how the golden circle and how the middle thing wherein you have to work on for improving the sale. Now, this is probably the most important, the why, the core, your belief, the purpose, and the you. Till date, it's like 6 years, and for my nephew, I'm his favorite. I know everyone would be calling me, why don't you get married? It's your age to get married. And the same conversation goes at my home also. And when it went on at one fine evening, my nephew, who was then 4.5, told my mother, Dadi, after 2 years, I'll marry her. and my mother, his daddy, was like, how did you do this? Like, I didn't do anything. He's told. I have already done everything because of that connect that I have built. That connect which gave me immense joy was the reason of the story that I told in the beginning. That joy of giving was even more important than how I'm doing things and what I'm doing for them. So the why of your sales to whosoever you are connected with, either it's a demo meeting at Toastmasters or it's a treasurer report that we are going to listen to. All what matters is the purpose, the reason, the belief. And why I have written the you is nothing but this in entirety. You are nothing but your purpose, because you are the human connect here. And every sales has the most important element as a human connect. Even if I buy an idea from Devina, I would buy it strongly and I'll buy it more powerfully if I like her as a person, if I believe in her, if I connect with her belief. Because the emotional connect is stronger than any other logical or research connect. She might not know everything about me, but I would be sold if she connects with me emotionally. And that is where the sales pitch get close. That is no more important in any of the knowledge, any of the research, any of the dressing up, etiquette of setting, mirroring, and all the concepts, if you can't give that sales a human touch. A human touch can help you sell anything and everything. So whenever you sell anything, be it at your family, or with your friends, or at Toastmasters, or at your work, just step back once and think of the why. The purpose of doing this in the first place. Is it only for money? Is it only for the fame? Is it only for the people? Or is it for serving? is it for helping others, or because you strongly believe that this is going to make it happen? Closing it with a beautiful quote that I really love from Patricia Pritt: you never close a sale, you always open a relationship. It's not about the business or money or anything else in the world. Don't worry if the sales is not closed. Be happy that you were emotionally connected and you get a repeat business because there was an emotional connect and a wonderful relationship you made. Thank you so much. Over to you, Tulsa.